Hey guys, today we're going to look at classifying rational numbers. This is lesson five, and the notes are going to start on page 69. So the first thing that we want to look at is that any number that can be expressed as a fraction is called a rational number. And a rational number can be expressed as a terminating decimal or a repeating decimal. Let's take a look at this. So it says, draw lines from each word to its matching statement. A terminating decimal is a decimal that is going to, a terminating decimal is going to be one that is going to end. So this is kind of a little odd, but they're saying that your terminating decimal is the decimal that has a repeating digit of zero. Okay, that's one way to look at it. I always think of a terminating decimal as one that ends. It doesn't repeat. It doesn't keep going. So here's an example. You've got 625 thousandths. And then you have just the opposite. Your repeating decimal would be a decimal form of a rational number, which would be one where it doesn't end. Okay. It just keeps repeating and repeating. So there you go. We're going to look at this, and hopefully this will make it a little bit more, it'll be easier to understand. So it says, Jude is buying fruit snacks for party favors. He asked the cashier for a half pound of fruit snacks. Express one half as a fraction. Okay. One half is a fraction. Like that, right? Because it's one part out of two. Two being the whole thing. Number two, identify the decimal that represents half a pound. Okay. Well, we can set it up where it's equal to 100, right? We know that 2 times 50 is 100. So 1 times 50 would be your answer right there. So you would have 50 over 100, which is read as 50 hundredths. Now, also, you could have, if you just divided, I'll do it over here, into 1.0. 2 goes into 10 five times. So you might have had 5/10. So I'm going to put 5/10. So it says, suppose Jude wanted to buy 1/3 of a pound. What decimal would the scale show? Okay. So 1/3 looks like that, right? Okay. 3 does not divide equally into 100. So we can't set it up where it's equal to 100. So I'm going to have to just divide. So I'm going to divide 3 into 1.0. So 3 is going to go into 10, 3 times, which is 9. Subtract, you get 1, add a 0, bring it down. 3 goes into 10, 3 times, and you see how this would just keep going on and on and on. And so this would be your repeating decimal. You can indicate that it's repeating. There's the dot notation like that. Also, I like the bar notation myself, where you just put the bar over the numbers that repeat. Okay. Now looking on the back, we're going to talk about, the group of rational numbers. I love, love, love this diagram. Okay. So it says rational numbers can be expressed as fractions. Now, this part right here may be a little bit, you might look at that and go, what are they talking about? It says A divided by B, where A and B are integers, B cannot be zero, okay? So basically, they're just saying that rational numbers are fractions and your denominator cannot be zero. Okay. Okay. So looking at this model, they start in the middle with the whole numbers. And so what I want you to do is we're going to kind of switch for a second and go to our journals. In our journals, we're going to put some definitions. And so let's take a look at your next available page in your journal. And I'm going to switch. Thank you for being so flexible with me. And we're going to get some definitions in here that are important for what we're going to be looking at. Okay. So the first thing is, we're just going to kind of draw this diagram in our journal too. First thing we want to do is we want to look at inside the very inside circle, and you have, I'm going to do natural numbers. Okay. You know, that means that hashtag is numbers, right? Natural numbers are like counting numbers. When we count, we always start with one. We don't start counting with zero, do we? No. We start counting with one, two, three, dot, dot, dot. Then our next group, we're going to pick up some more people in our next group. And I like to do it like this to show that we're going to include this, and then we're going to get some more. This next group is going to be our whole numbers. Our whole numbers, we're going to have our natural numbers, our counting numbers, one, two, three, four, and so on, but we're going to add zero. So we're adding zero, and then one, two, three, dot, dot, dot. Then we're going to go a little bit bigger. This time, we're going to add our integers. And our integers would include the whole numbers, which includes the natural numbers, but this time it includes the negative whole numbers or the negative, let me show you. It'd be like 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. But then we're going to include their opposites. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, dot, dot, dot. So the integers are their whole numbers and their opposites. And then we're going to go one group bigger, okay, including the counting numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers. This time, we're going to include rational numbers. Rational numbers would be like any of our decimals, it would be our, any of our fractions, positive or negative, mixed numbers. Repeating decimals, all of that would be added. Okay. So now let's put some definitions down. The first one we want to do is let's do our natural numbers. If at any point you need to pause this so that you can, you know, catch up or whatever, just feel free to. Okay. Sorry, didn't mean to shake it. So natural numbers are counting numbers starting with one. Okay, our next one would be our whole numbers. Okay, whole numbers would be all of our natural numbers plus zero. Okay, integers. Are your whole numbers? And their opposites. And then we would have rational numbers. Are numbers that can be written as a fraction or a ratio. They look the same, right? Which is a comparison of two quantities. I know that's a lot to write, but I think that will be really, really good for you to have those. Okay? So now we're going to go back to where we were on our paper with our notes. So right here in the middle, it says fractions terminating and repeating decimals, percents, and integers are all rational numbers. Every rational number can be expressed as a decimal by dividing the numerator by the denominator. Okay, to indicate the number pattern that repeats indefinitely, use the bar notation, which is what I was talking about before. But look at these two. This one says 0.545454. So see, there's a pattern that repeats. It's not just a single digit. Here, you've got a negative 0.583333, and it keeps going. So the only thing that's repeating here is just the 3. Not the entire decimal. So you want to be careful when you're putting your bar notation and make sure that you are just putting it above what is repeating. Example number one, they're showing you how to express 5/12 as a decimal, and they're doing it with division. And the thing about the repeating decimal is your remainder will never be zero. See? And you'll end up, you'll keep getting the same remainder each time. And if you keep trying to divide and divide and divide, you're going to be doing the same thing over and over. And so it's showing you that the 6 is what repeated there. Okay. On page 71, it has an example at the top, or a practice problem for us to do. You've got 1/6. So we're going to divide, I'm going to go over here and do it. We're going to divide 6 into 1.0. Will 6 go into 1? No. Will 6 go into 10? Yes. We subtract. 10 minus 6 is 4. Annex is 0. Bring it down. 6 will go into 40. That would be 6 times, which is 36. Subtract and get 4. Oh, look. Look what's happening. Okay. You would just keep, and that would be 36, and you would have 4. See? So the 6 is what's repeating. So our answer is 0.16. If you want to put 2 6s there, you can. If you just want to put 1 6 there, you can. But just the bar needs to be above the 6. Okay. Right here, it's talking about your what I kind of just did on the other page, where your class, you know, in our journal, where you're classifying rational numbers using a visual representation. And so right here, they're looking at, they just did whole numbers, integers, and rational numbers, and they're wanting you to put the numbers in the correct location. So if you had a negative 7 is going to be an integer, isn't it? Okay. And it's also considered a rational number, okay? It says, so place negative 7 inside the integer circle, but not inside the whole number circle. So if it's right here, this means that it's an integer and a rational number, okay? So if we go over here, we can get 7 is an integer, and it's also rational number, okay? Looking at the number five would be a whole number, which means that 5 would be a whole number. Excuse me. It would also be an integer, and it would also be a rational number. 3/7. 3/7 is a fraction, right? So that means that it's only a rational number. It is not anything else. Then you've got the negative 36/100 that's repeating. And that would be considered a rational number as well. So that'd be your negative 36/100, and that would be rational. Okay, so looking down here, let's look at B. You've got negative 4 8/10. Okay, that would be rational. Negative 31, that would be an integer and rational. Negative 2/9, or not negative 2/9, it's just 2/9, would be rational. All right. Okay. So now looking on page 72, you've got the guided practice. You've got guided practice problems here that you can do for practice. Your assignment is going to be page 73. I did put that assignment in your modules, so you know which numbers to do. I believe I said 1 through 14, but just double check me, okay? All right, well, if you have questions, let me know, and I will see you in class. Have a great day.